Welcome to Kyrandia 3, I'm your host, lostwolfe.
Actually, I like dumps.
I'm glad you do, Malcolm. This is an extra. In this extra, we're going to get out of Kyrandia. I'm going to do it with the Pegasus potion. Now, as with all of these, there's a lot of setup to do before we can actually get it done. And hopefully I get the bits that I need out of here before we get going. So, first of all, as you can see, I did literally just start a new game. So, let's go digging. That's good, we need one of those, and for this run,
I wonder if I can sell.
We actually get exactly what we need right off the bat. We don't need anything else.
I'd better go. Doesn't.
So we are going to do that, we're going to go home, because there's a handful of things that we need to get
one way of,
from home.
Get in.
Oh goodness. There we go. Whee!
What are you?
Okay, so we're gonna break into here.
That worked perfectly.
And we're going to go and get the staff. I'm gonna try not to forget the staff on any of these runs because you need the staff for the rest of the game.
What?
And unfortunately, it's very easy to miss the staff if you're starting a fresh game.
Look what was hidden under the bed.
And the other thing that we need from here is just the acorn on a string.
See what's inside. Wonderful.
Well, not the string. Okay. Now that we have that, we are going to go just do right of here. We need a couple of things. Okay, we need the log for sure. And the other thing that we need to do is we need to go here and we need to get 2 sesame seeds.
Sesame seeds.
Okay, we don't really need water or anything because we're going to get that eventually. But we have basically all the ingredients we need for where we're going. There's one more thing that we'd like to do before we get things started off here.
I like clouds.
Very good, Malcolm. So part of what we need to do, he's talking about the Kyrandian school. What we need to do is we need to make ourselves a disguise. And the quickest, easiest way to make a disguise is just to lure the squirrel on over. And then to do exactly like we saw in the introduction of the game, which is to hypnotize it.
Time to hypnotize Mr. Squirrel. You're getting sleepy. Very sleepy. I can't believe that old trick still works. I love this guy.
I can't decide if Gunther is talking about you or if he's talking about the squirrel. Anyway, we need the squirrel. Now you can stick the squirrel in your inventory and you can actually carry 2 of them around if you want to. But we don't need to do that for where we're going. We're just gonna use this.
This squirrel might make a nice hat.
As a hat. And this is part of a disguise. This is enough of a disguise to kind of fool casual onlookers. Okay, we need to go and do one other thing down here. I've been neglecting doing this because it's a bit of a rigmarole. But we need to get a fish. While we're here, actually, let me explain the toy maker. So the toy maker is attached to a book over here, and the book, if you click it, tells it what tells you what you're going to end up with. Right now,
hey, the old book of toy blueprints.
We're gonna end up
amazing.
with a toy soldier. And if we flip any of these levers, we'll end up with a different toy. So that's a toy ball.
I hope they didn't close this place just because... No toy.
And the toy horse. And those are the three toys that you can make. We're going to make a toy horse real quickly. You stick your log in, and then you hit green for go. Each toy needs a different thing.
It made a rocking horse.
It's a tiny rocking horse, but it'll do for what we need to get doing. What we need to do. We need to get out. Oh, no, wait.
No toys.
We need to go down here. This was the whole reason I was trying to come here. Down we go.
Ow.
So, among other things, we need an eel. We need an eel. No, seriously, fish. Why aren't we fishing?
Great, an eel.
Fantastic. After I had to fight with that several times. Okay. Well, we have the eel. We need to replace our empty jar with a full jar.
Loaded with water.
And now we are essentially all set to get the Pegasus potion. We have everything we need. We need one last little item, and that's the item where I may have to cut while I try and get it, because it's going to take a while to actually achieve. You'll remember that over here, and down, and on my left from here, there is a mime. So the thing about this mime, right, is we need the mime to ditch his clothes because we need his outfit. Well, where are we going? We need the Pegasus outfit. There are a couple of outfits you can get. The mime is one of them. And we need the mime specifically so that we can go and talk to someone that we've seen before. But right now, the mime is busy doing his thing over here. We need him to turn away from us, and then we're going to stick a fish into his camp. But that takes a little bit of waiting around for. So if this doesn't take too long, I'll just keep it in. If it takes a while, I will just edit away to the point where the mime turns around. And you can see me actually sticking the eel into his hat. Because that may take a bit of waiting around for. Oh my god, that took a long time.
Now we're having fun. We're off to a good start.
I probably have cut away now, waiting for the mime, more video than I've actually recorded, because that's random, and he wasn't doing it. Anyway, so one of the things that you can do is we can open this up here.
That always works.
And
I can't believe this disguise worked.
I can't believe it either. Now we are here. The first thing we need to do is we need to turn Malcolm from normal to lying.
I think it's time to start telling more lies.
And the reason we need to do that is because
that's the way to do it. Lie to these idiots.
it's probably tricky to tell given YouTube and everything. But over here, this is where the mime's outfit is, and we need to get that. The only way to get that is to cause chaos in the boss. The way we're going to do that is by, you can see here, this is a mechanism for adjusting the temperature of the boss. I don't want to make anyone feel hurt or anything, so I'm going to turn this down to cold.
You're not messing with those controls, are you?
No, sir. I would never touch such delicate equipment.
Good.
And here we go. We're going to change the temperature.
Hey, what's the ruckus?
And now that the bar superintendent is occupied, we can grab this. Oh, spoils. It wouldn't do to change right in front of the guy, so we're gonna go to the screen here and get our well-earned outfit on. Malcolm is gonna say a funny thing now, and I'm just gonna let him talk.
This mime outfit would ruin the sophisticated look of the squirrel on my head.
I like that. It's silly. Anyway, so what he's basically saying is, we have a hypnotized squirrel on our head. We need to get that unhypnotized so that we can wear the mime outfit.
Now to undo the squirrel trance. That poor squirrel got away fast.
Right. And now we can wear the mime outfit.
This smelly mime outfit might look good.
The final thing that we need to do here is we need to trigger something that we haven't actually triggered yet. I'm just gonna head this way and then to the left. And I think we want to go here.
I remember this place. Here comes somebody.
What a ride. Hey, it's you. What are you doing here?
Now, the thing is that under ordinary circumstances, Santi would recognize who you are because you're not wearing a disguise, but wearing a disguise now. I'm not going to lie to her. I am not into lying to her or being mean to her, so let's talk to her.
Hello, Mr. Mime. You can talk. I won't tell anyone.
And that's all that she's going to get out of us when we're normal.
Don't be shy. I won't bite.
It's not that. I was chewing on some sesame seeds.
And we can do that.
Maybe if I might.
That's nice.
You can talk. I won't tell anyone. Don't be shy. I won't bite.
Excuse me, I had some cotton candy stuck on my teeth.
I find it amusing that the difference between normal and nice is cotton candy and sesame seeds. Anyway, Xanthia is now in the game. This is important to do, because if you don't do this, Xanthia won't be on Kyrandia Island, and you won't be able to talk to her in other circumstances. Which is precisely what we're going to do now. So if we didn't set up that whole Xanthea being on Kyrandia, but this is the Mystic's Lodge or the Magic Lodge, it would not be open. You just get a description of it.
The Magician's Lodge.
You just get that. But we're going to go inside because Xanthea's here now, and we can deal with her.
Oh, hello there, Mr. Mime. We just loved you at the circus.
Okay, so again, I'm going to stick to being nice to her.
Hello, Mr. Mime. We loved the show.
Oh, yeah. Thanks.
We're all going over to the Isle of Cats to see your next show, too.
Great.
So, now we know that we're going to end up on the Isle of Cats if we go as a mime. Let's talk to her about that a little bit more.
If I miss my boat, can I get a ride with you?
Why would the circus sail without you?
Well, not everybody appreciates my art. Sometimes they play jokes on me. So, can I get some of that potion you're making?
It's not done yet. I need to add essence of horse.
Okay, so she's making some potion. Presumably it will be helpful for us because Malcolm has taken an interest in it. So let's see if we can give her some toy horse for her potion. First, I just want to talk to her again and just see if I've got all the dialogue.
If I miss my boat,
why would...
Okay, we got all the lines we're likely to get. Let's give her the rocking horse, because that is a kind of horse.
I do need essence of horse to complete the potion, but I'd rather use my own ingredients, thank you.
Which basically cheerfully says that she's not into the rocking horse, the horse that we have here. Ooh, I didn't do a very important thing for my setup here. I completely forgot. Won't take too long.
Ow.
We need a second eel. Goodness gravy.
Great, an eel.
Thank the Lord. I need to find where that hotspot is and stick with it. Anyway, so we need to fertilize the seeds. And we need to head back up to Xanthea. Sorry, I completely forgot about that. So it turns out that she's not going to let us use our horse as part of a potion. So that's sort of
I'll bet these little dynamos can knock over that cheap display case.
Distract our way to being able to do that.
Oh my gosh. Marco is going to kill me when he sees this.
Marco, for the sake of people who haven't played the second game, is her erstwhile sort of weird boyfriend from the second game. Anyway, we have an empty flask. We have a potion that needs completion.
That did something. I wonder what.
Now that the potion is completed, since she said she needed essence of horse, we can get some of it. Now there's a Pegasus potion, and we're done. Right, so we need to go this way. And then down, I believe. To the left. This isn't the best way to go about doing this, but I don't think there's too many more expedient ways of getting to where we need to get. That's all good. We could try to get to where we're going by using the Pegasus potion, as we are.
I'm not trying this while I'm wearing this smelly mime outfit.
But he obviously doesn't like the mime outfit. Now, this is a UI thing and it's a bit weird, but to get the mime outfit, we ended up with this hanger. We need to put the mime outfit back on the hanger.
So much for the clown outfit.
And now that we've done that, we can escape Kyrandia. I love the way that Gunther is sort of, also when you turn into a Pegasus, he gets sort of after effects of it. I love this little scene too, because it's very Monkey Island-y, right down to the music that we have going on in the background. But that is about it. When I see you next, we're going to do some of the other methods of escape, because we haven't exhausted them all. I'm S. Lostwolfe. This was an extra in which we took the Pegasus potion, escaped Kyrandia. Now we're going to get revenge. I will see you all soon. I hope that you've enjoyed this silly little sidetrack thing. And I will be back soon with another one. Have a wonderful evening. And good night for now, folks.